Hello and welcome from quite an empty bicycle parking garage from the HKHS railway station. This video I'll be showing you the newest refurbished intercity trains of the Netherlands. These are the third and fourth generations of the firm trains. The color scheme is totally different from what we're used to for long distance trains in the Netherlands. We already saw something like this on the locomotives the NS used for the night jet trains. I will tell you more details about this with the use of voiceover. It won't be a trip report, it's just a train review. When you want to see the other firm trains, I did a trip report once on the longest domestic intercity train in the Netherlands. It runs from Maastricht to Den Helder. And in that video, I'll show you the older firm trains, so the first generation that has been refurbished, and the fourth generation that doesn't need to be refurbished yet. Anyway, when you like this video, give me a thumbs up on YouTube. When you like to see more train related videos, subscribe to my channel. This channel is made for long distance and international train traveling, and there will be some more exciting videos soon. From the end of September, you can expect more exciting videos, because then I'll make a nice trip. I'm really looking forward to this. But for now, you have to deal with videos from the Netherlands or near and around my home country. Anyway, give me a thumbs up when you like this video, subscribe when you like to see more. When you want to follow me during my journeys, you can also find me on Instagram. It's just Train Viking, pops up somewhere on the screen right now. And when you want to support this channel financially, I do have a Patreon account as well. You can already support this channel for €1, dollar or pound per month. I'll tell you a little bit more at the end of this video about that. Anyway, without any further ado, let's roll the intro. Before I go into detail and describe you everything, let's just have a look on the new branding of the intercity trains in the Netherlands. Until now, domestic intercity trains in the Netherlands are very easy recognizable. They are yellow and do have a blue stripe at the side. This also counts for the intercity trains that run between the Netherlands and Belgium. The newly ordered intercities that will use the high-speed lines and also go to Belgium do have these color schemes as well. These trains haven't been put in operation yet, so maybe this will change in the near future, because there are not a lot of these trains in the Netherlands at this moment. You can already see the new color scheme on the Vectron locomotives that are being used for the Nightjet and the intercity trains to Berlin. I guess the greatest transformation is at the outside of these trains. So first, let's have a closer look at the exterior. Icons like bikes or a wheelchair do indicate where you can enter the train when you're traveling with a bike or when you do have mobility problems. An extra blue thin line at the side does indicate exactly where the first class is, but of course you can also look at the numbers 1 and 2, and the silent compartment is easy recognizable from outside as well. LED screens at the side of the train do indicate the final station. In total, the NS owns 176 of these electrical multiple units, and these trains have been ordered in 4 different batches. The first batch is the biggest one. These trains are already totally refurbished and do contain of 81 electrical multiple units. Both the second and third livery. This consists of 45 electrical multiple units, and that's the livery we'll talk about today in this video. I already showed you the exterior. For now, let's take a look at the interior. At the total back and front of the train, you'll find these things at the wall where you can stand and rest a little bit. At all railings, the class has been clearly given, so you know what class is where, up and down. And throughout the train, in both the compartments but also between the carriages, you find information screens that will host route information. The second class comes in a 2x2 configuration, and all second class seats are blue. There's a variety of seats in airline style of composition and classical train compositions. At the upper deck, you find a bit more seats in airline style composition. First of all, I do have to say the leg space is really good. The size of the tray table though, it's kind of disappointing. At this seat in front of you, you'll find a coat hanger, and when you're traveling on the lower deck, this will be at the side. And between the seats, there's a small garbage can. There are no sunscreen when you're traveling with a lot of luggage. I would not recommend you to go to the upper decks, because here you just have a little bit less luggage space. Something that's new, you will find a lot of USB power points over here. And priority seats have been marked very well in these refurbished trains. At the upper deck, you won't find luggage racks. Instead of that, you can put some suitcases between the back end of some seats where you have some space for, well, store luggage. The seats that do face each other, both at the upper and the lower deck, do have a small table at the window, and below the table you'll find a garbage can. At the lower deck you'll find small luggage racks, but there's also extra space for luggage, for example over here. You also find these couches over here, so-called lounges. They're slightly smaller than in the first refurbished train. Between the carriages there are also availabilities to just have a sit. Some of them are more comfortable and some of them are not that comfortable, like for example these folding seats. However, these folding seats, they look pretty comfortable. USB charging points can be found all over the place. However, there's one point in this train where you also find a regular power plug in second class, and that's over here. And spots where you can park bikes can also be found at several spots between the carriages in these trains. Before I show you the first class, let's take a look at the toilets, or as another famous train YouTube channel would say, toilets time. These toilets are quite big, and you can also turn them into a nursery space for babies, what's very useful. These toilets are also easy accessible for people with mobility problems. In the first refurbished firm trains, there used to be a urinal as well. That's not the case in these trains anymore. Toilets are nice and modern, but nothing really special when you ask me. When you know a train that does have a very special toilet, just let me know in the comments, so maybe I can make a toilet report about it. The first class comes in a 2x1 configuration, and in first class the seats do have a red color. The seats are not that much wider as in the second class, but there's some extra space between the seats, and over here you also find a regular power plug. Just like the second class, there is an extra space for luggage over here, and right next to this you will find the so-called lounge, so the couch. Over here in the first class you also find more power plugs. And of course, just like the second class, at the lower deck you also find overhead luggage racks. But once again, these luggage racks are not that big. The seats that do come in an airplane composition do have a footrest. Just like in second class, you find a garbage can between the seats, and there's a small tray table. Just like second class, at the lower deck you find a coat hanger at the side, and at the upper deck it's in the seat in front of you. All armrests can be put up and down, and the seats in first class are reclinable as well, although it's not that much. Unlimited free Wi-Fi is available, although the speed is not that fast. And when you're traveling in a wheelchair, please make sure these trains don't have barrier-free access, so it's better to call for assistance. That it's for this video. I do have to say, you can't reserve seats and there's no dining car available. Before COVID, on some routes, there used to be something like a catering service that went by every now and then. Distances in the Netherlands are not that long, and trains do run very frequently, between every 15 minutes and every hour. Most routes it's every 30 minutes, so there's no need for this. Although I'm posting this video early in August in 2021, these trains are already in service for about 1.5 months at the moment I'm posting this video. Maybe you already traveled with one of these trains. Just let me know, what is your experience? How did you like these trains? Or what is your experience on Dutch long distance trains in general? Just let me know in the comments, I'm curious. As I mentioned in the introduction, there will be some exciting trip reports soon. I'm not going into much details right now because COVID can still ruin everything. But very soon I'll be going to Scandinavia. That will be mid-August. And mid-September I'll be going with my girlfriend on a longer trip to Switzerland and Italy. Also do some panoramic trains and of course some high-speed trains. And to Scandinavia there will also be some ferries included. So stay tuned for that. So just when you're interested in those trip reports or other trip reports, just subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the bell button so you get notified when I upload new videos. And hopefully this entire situation with COVID will be
coming a little bit better soon, because when we can travel by train to outside of Europe again, I will definitely do so. And of course, when you like this video, give me a thumbs up. As I mentioned in the introduction of this video, I will also tell you a little bit more about Patreon. In my last video, I made a kind of, well, summary for Patreon, and that's the video I will play now. Anyway, thanks for watching and see you on my next video.
When you want to support this channel, you can like the videos, you can leave a comment, and you can also subscribe to my channel. This is very much appreciated. But there's something more you can do. I do have a Patreon account as well, and you can also support this channel financially. You can already do this from 1 euro, dollar or pound per month. I started this channel back in September 2019, when I went to China and Korea by train. Back then, I worked for a company that was selling international train tickets all over the world, so therefore I do know a lot about train fares. Due to COVID, all employees got fired. I also lost my job, but I found a new job pretty soon after that. Not in the train business though. This channel is mainly focusing on international and long distance train traveling, just to show you what it's like to travel on a more sustainable way of transportation. So, show you what it's like to travel on train instead of taking the car or the plane. And while I'm doing this, I'm trying to answer as many questions as people ask me. At the moment, I worked for the travel agency that was selling international train tickets. Even though COVID made it a bit more challenging for me to make new videos, and the videos are not as exciting as I planned it to be, Patreon is stimulating me in a good way to create more and new content. Apart from that, it also offers me a unique way to interact in a different way with my audience. Everything I earn on this channel, both Patreon and being monetized on YouTube, will go directly into the channel again. I don't earn anything on this channel, as a matter of fact, it costs me money. But I don't mind, because I really like to do this. So, when you like to support this channel financially, you can go to patreon.com/trainviking, and you also have some extra benefits.